Welcome back to Little Norton, everybody, where the sun is shining in autumn. We are still in the first day of autumn. I'm gonna. Oh, they don't need topping up. I must have done that already. How are we doing in here? A little bit of manure. We're gonna be okay. Let's have a look on here. So. Ooh. I still don't understand why the pigs have got water. So we've got six cows. They've got everything they need except total mixed ration, which we can't do because we don't have anything to mix it yet. Health is 71%, so that is going up from where it was. So I am relatively happy for the moment. Although we don't have an estimation on next. Oh, there we go, we got one. Half a year we're gonna get one. Oh, excellent. Okay, so we are reproducing. We have three pregnancies, which is fantastic. So I've loaded this onto the trailer. That is the last of our straw. And what I'm going to do for now is I'm going to take this round and just stick it in our shed on the trailer. So I'm not going to take it off, I'm going to leave it there until we're ready to sell it, hopefully, if we can. Am I going to get out of here? Yeah, I don't see why not. Yeah, so I'm going to leave it on the trailer for now because we don't have any more bales or anything to mess around with at this point. As you can see, I stacked the first lot there, which we're going to keep. I'm probably going to turn this vat shed into bale shed itself and take out the storage of machinery and things. Just because I think it would be better to have our bales in there, then we could fill the back up and just stick some machinery in front of it. I don't like that the sides are exposed, and I know seasons can mess around with bales and things. So stick the doits back in here. Excellent, we're done with you for now. We'll get into the Merlot, and to be fair, the Merlot can be put away as well. I'll take the grab off. I want to take the spikes off. Yeah. We'll take the spikes off, and then we're going to see if we can get the contract on field 49. However, I have spoken to a few people about this issue of renting the field. There is a possibility that it is conflicting with seasons, and then there's also another possibility that the field needs to be fully ready to cut before you can cut it with the leasing mod. So I'm a little bit torn. Do I risk renting the field again and letting it go another day until the field is completely ripened? Or do I just try and get the contract on it? So I'm struggling with a decision on this. Because I'd like to fill that with soybeans. I'd like to lease it and fill it with soybeans. Because I think we'd get a lot of money. But I just don't know. I just don't know. Thank you for saving. Very kind. So, I've installed the contract refresh mod. I really need to make a decision. That is a lot of money for a transportation job. From the transport company to Old Oak. The transport company is here. Where is Old Oak? Is that the pub? No. You'd think it would be the pub, wouldn't you? There's no... I don't know where Old Oak is. I don't know where it is. Let's not get sidetracked by that Ceebur. So here we are in field 49. And good old dummy Ceebur forgot to press the record button when he started doing this. So I've got some things to explain. But first of all, we're going to put some hired help on. So off he goes. Okay, so, explanation. Right. So, field 49. We have jumped forward into day 2 of autumn. From where we started in the video. And we are currently running the Deutz and the Sammy in the field. Deutz is doing the baling, Sammy is doing the carting. And how did I get field 49 to work? Well, I was talking to some people, as I may have already said, and they suggested that I skip forward until the crop is at its utmost readiness for harvesting and try it again. I was a little bit reluctant to do this, so I experimented, and obviously it worked, and I just forgot to press record as we were getting into it. So we have leased the field again, so we got back to square one. We are getting all of the wheat off of it. We're baling up all the straw because we want to make as much money off of this field as we possibly can. And we can't be messing around. So a little trick I've discovered with this Vicon is that you can hold that bale until you've got the second bale ready to come out. And then you can drop them both together next to each other, and that means you can just pick up two bales on your forge? Can you just see that? Then drop it down. Can you drop that? Splendid. Helper bee has nearly a full grain tank. Okay. So yeah, you've missed an hour's worth of time lapse basically. I recorded, or what I thought was recording, was about an hour's worth of what was going to be cut down into a time lapse. But we've got that last bit of field left to do, so we're just cracking on, we're just getting on with it. Actually, I might bring us the time speed down a bit. That's when we'll lose data, we don't want that. Dropping them off. Jump out of the dogs, jump into Sammy. Get over here because he thinks he's finished. And I know he hasn't. So we've had, three carts, three grain carts already of wheat off of this field, which is good. Well, I think it's good anyway. We're about to get number four. This stupid shape field is going to be the bane of my life with this helper. Let's send him on his way anyway. We'll get this. Whoop. It's the quickest way down this field, this bounty. Probably wrong. So we'll get this load tipped, and then I will go into a time lapse to get the rest of this field done, which you can enjoy at your leisure. And that will be beautiful. Here we go. So, yeah, obviously, the plan is we're going to crash into the fence. We're going to plant in, turn those two fields into one. And we're going to plant our cereal crop in there, which will be whatever gives us the highest price for the cereal, because we want the straw to come off of it every year, obviously, although it doesn't look like we're going to need any this year at all. So this is trailer load number four. And that coffee was delightful. I'm not going to tell you whose brand it is, but it was February this year. We went away for a long weekend, stayed in the caravan, forgot to take any coffee with us, so went down to the little shop on the park, and all they had was this brand. Never had them before, tried it, absolutely fell in love with it. Like, it is amazing, it tastes absolutely fantastic. But obviously they're not paying me to say that, so I'm not going to tell you who it is. So there. What do you think? Gonna turn around or not? Let's time lapse. Once he's actually finished. Oh, doing it again. Once he's actually finished, we'll go and tidy up the. Oh, he thinks he's finished now. For goodness sakes. Dude can't catch a break. Not finished. Carry on. So, yeah, it's been a bit of a wonky episode. It's quite lucky that I caught the fact that I haven't recorded the first half of that, or else we wouldn't have got any of it. But yeah, once he's finished doing what he's pretending to do over there, which I think he's going to pretend he's finished again in a second, we'll finish up the little bits and pieces, shreddy bits and pieces, and then we'll get the rest of the field baled and see where we're at. I really need to start concentrating on that. Very handy that you can do that with this baler, though. If you can get the mid twos, like I said before, you'll be able to pick them up straight off the loader, straight onto the trailer, two at a time. You haven't got to go chasing them around, which is still be very nice. Very nice indeed. Once harvest is over, we will chop in the joints, the samming for a bigger tractor with more horses. And we will look at getting a planter. So we want that for future jobs. Come in again. So if anybody's interested, if you're a young YouTuber, new YouTuber, want or are interested in starting a YouTube channel with videos, predominantly Farming Simulator, but others as well. I run a group on Facebook. It's called Farming Simulator YouTube Community, and we're basically a big community. Loads and loads of us. We're like a family, and we all help each other, support each other, keep each other going when we need help, when we need that kick up a butt. And yeah, so if you're interested, come and join us on there. If you're not on Facebook, come and join us on our new Discord. The link will be in the description, and you can come and chat to everybody, watch videos, you can come and chat to me. I will be on there talking, so if you want to just come and talk to me, join the Discord. You can come and talk to me on there. I will be there. So I'm just going to jump up, get the rest of this field done, and then we'll get everything sorted. Alright? Okay, so we've got the last two strips. Pick up there, we've got that little bit over there to pick up, so I'm just going to pick up all the scraggly bits first. As he misses some, and makes more scraggly bits. Flatten that down. Absolutely struggling to get a bail. Okay then. There we go. Gotta move the Sammy. I can't do this in a water. Not to worry. Actually, we've got that by the combine because we need to empty the combine. Oh, it's tight, it's tight. Gonna stick it in the edge, we'll be alright. Ish. Just trying to get through now, couldn't. Well, this has been a. Even though it went wrong, and I haven't recorded enough misprints and stuff, you know. The whole process has turned out to be quite fruitful. We've got lots of bales. Not going to get that from any other. So we'll turn it off. We'll jump into the combine. Is that going to miss? Of course it's going to miss. Here we go. It's the fastest unloading combine I've had. apart from that, versatile. The versatile is phenomenal. But yeah. So we take this load. I think we're going to call it a day for this episode. I know it's all been really time-lapsey and all that, but yeah, we get those bales in. Need to get those bales in. Store them in the shed because they ain't going anywhere yet. Check a few vitals before we log off. So our last load of harvest, our last load for harvest. We're not going to put this trailer in that shed now, are we? I'll put it in this one. That will do it for now. And we're going to want the bale cart. We'll stick that on the Sammy list, though. I'll get that over there. Still no news on Merlot being updated. Oh, I need to unload the bale cart. Well, we won't do that right away, will we? Okay. Right, so, yes, we're going to check some, let's stand on the old Deutz. Loads of bales. So, thank you for saving, very kind of you. That was the wrong one. That is the right one. Created bales, 65, we've got 65 bales in there. So in total, we've got 133, sorry. And so far, we have played 25 hours, 43 minutes. Outstanding. Okie dokie. So what else do we want to check? We want to check the prices of, no, we don't want to check prices of that. We don't want to check prices of this. So what is high? Wheat is down. Oats is standard. Barley is up. We don't have none of that. Rape is up. Going up. We don't have soybeans. And bales is zero. Can't even sell it to biogas. Ooh. May have to go a different route with these bales. We will have to wait and see. Okay. Especially if the price doesn't come up. 133 in total. Goodness me. Thanks for watching this Hawky Borky one, everyone. Thanks for sticking with it. Stay safe. May the weather be with you.